The European Space Agency, ESA, has just picked an industrial team to construct the first experimental payload to extract oxygen from our moon's surface. The consortium, which includes AVS, Metallicis, the Open University, and Redwire Space Europe, is led by Thales Alenia Space, an aerospace manufacturer specializing in the space industry. The manufacturing company signed a study contract with ESA on February 23rd of this year, worth 1 million euros. The idea of colonizing the moon is not a question of if anymore. Space agencies around the world are now focusing on when and how to do that. While for some, establishing a permanent human space presence on the moon is a matter of destiny, for others, it's a matter of survival. For today's people, the moon is what the New World was to Europeans 600 years ago. They paid a number of visits there, but it took time to work up the courage to send people there to stay. Now, dreams of creating human settlements on the moon are becoming reality faster than most expect. The main task for the winning team is to produce a small piece of equipment that will evaluate the prospect of building larger lunar plants to extract propellant for spacecraft, breathable air for astronauts, and metallic raw materials for equipment. Our moon is not so barren after all. The fine lunar soil contains metals such as iron, aluminum, and titanium. The surface material, known as regolith, also contains significant amounts of oxygen, as well as frozen water at the poles, which could be put through electrolysis to provide hydrogen and oxygen for rocket propellant. Samples returned from the moon confirmed that regolith is made up of 40 to 50% oxygen by weight, its single most abundant element. Oxygen is bound up chemically as oxides, however, in the form of minerals or glass, so we won't be able to use it immediately. Scientists, using a prototype oxygen plant at the European Space Research and Technology Center, ESTEC, have shown a promising extraction method. The plant uses an electrolysis-based process to separate simulated regolith into metals and oxygen. Take a look at this image. On the left side is a pile of simulated lunar soil, or regolith, while on the right is the same pile after essentially all the oxygen has been extracted from it, leaving a mixture of metal alloys. The new piece of tech will need to extract 50 to 100 grams of oxygen from lunar regolith while delivering precision measurements of performance and gas concentrations. ESA's goal is to remove 70% of disposable oxygen from the sample. The interesting part is it will have to do all this super fast. More accurately, within 10 days, because that's how long the solar-powered tech will be available. David Benz, the systems engineer at ESA's concurrent design facility, said the payload needs to be compact, low power, and able to fly on a range of potential lunar landers, including ESA's own European Large Logistics Lander, shortly referred to as EL3. The EL3 is a versatile system designed to support a variety of missions. It aims to provide cargo and logistics services for NASA-led lunar missions via Artemis, and support a European mission to study the lunar South Pole with a robotic laboratory derived from the designed sample fetch rover. Extracting oxygen from lunar soil along with usable metals will definitely change the game for lunar exploration. This will help future explorers reach a level of self-sustainability so that they won't have to count on long and expensive supply lines from Earth. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and click the notification bell so you do not miss any upcoming videos.